Hello! Happy Valentine's Day and welcome to Bible Discovery! To start off today, I have a game for us to play. I'm going to put up some pictures of the inside of different fruits and want to see if you can tell what fruit they are. Are you ready? We'll start with an easy one. How about this? Do you know what it is? That's right, that was an apple. You probably all got that. Okay, here's another easy one. I think this is something we all like. Yeah, watermelon. You got that one too, I bet. Okay, a little bit trickier this time. How about this? Did you guess kiwi? Right, it was kiwi. Okay, here's the next one. Have any of you had this one? It was a mango. I love mango. Okay, last one. This is the hardest one. What's this? That's a tricky one. Maybe some of you haven't seen this one before. That's a dragon fruit. Looks interesting, doesn't it? Now, knowing the inside of those fruits might have been pretty easy for you, but knowing what's on the inside of a person isn't always that easy. Jesus taught about the way his followers should live, and when we truly love Jesus, that love inside of us will change the way we behave on the outside. Let's watch a story of Jesus teaching.
Great crowds of people followed Jesus wherever he went. One day, Jesus went up on a mountain. He sat down and began to teach about the kingdom of God. First, Jesus taught about the blessings that come to those who follow him. He said, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for the kingdom of heaven is theirs. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the humble, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled.
Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness, for the kingdom of heaven is theirs."
Then Jesus taught how believers should live. Jesus said that believers are the light of the world. Let your light shine before others so that they may see the good things you do and choose to praise God. Then Jesus taught about God's law. Jesus did not come to get rid of the law, but to obey it perfectly. He said that to enter heaven, a person can't just look righteous on the outside like the righteous leaders. A person must be righteous on the inside too, obeying God for the right reasons.
Jesus said, "Love your enemies and pray for them. When you give to people who are poor, give in secret. And when you pray, don't pray just so that people will hear you." Jesus taught the people how to pray. He also said, "Forgive others. If you forgive those who sin against you, God will forgive you too. But if you don't forgive them, God will not forgive you."
Jesus said, "Do not collect treasures on earth. They can be destroyed or stolen. Collect treasures in heaven instead. For where your treasure is, that is where your heart will be also." He taught that God provides for his people. Jesus taught the people many things. When he finished teaching, the crowds were amazed because he taught them like one who had authority.
Jesus taught people what it means to follow him. He taught how people should live, how they should treat one another, and how to love God. People who trust in Jesus live to honor God and show what his kingdom is like.
Hey
Hey there, I'm Pastor Brian, and it's time for Questions from Kids. Evan from Nashville, Tennessee asks,
what kinds of treasures will there be in heaven?
Great question, Evan. You know, the Bible does speak of treasures in heaven. Jesus mentions them. If you read the book of Revelation, you'll see that heaven's described with streets of gold. We often hear that. And so it's natural to kind of wonder, what kind of treasures might we look forward to? Now, here's the thing. I think to answer this question, we really have to press in and understand what treasures really are. A treasure is something we value, right? And so earthly treasures tend to be financial things, physical things. We may have treasures of game systems or clothing or cars or whatever the case may be, houses. And those are all good things. There's nothing wrong with those. But are those really treasures? I would argue they're not. First of all, they're all gonna break or get lost or something at some point. They're, you know, I can think of game systems that are obsolete now. And so really, should we put our treasures in things that are that temporary? Of course not. And do those things truly give us joy? And the answer is no. I mean, we can enjoy them, but they don't give us joy that's lasting. The Bible tells us that our greatest treasure is Christ. He is the one thing, the one person who gives us joy and lasts forever. And so what awaits us in heaven? What treasures await us? Well, the greatest treasure is Jesus. We're gonna be with Jesus, see him face to face, and be able to worship him and spend time with him for eternity. That's a great treasure to look forward to. But there's another treasure that I'm really looking forward to, and it's this, one another. That God has called us to be a community, a family of faith, and that we have one another that we enjoy spending time with and worshiping to God together with. And so heaven is not just you and Jesus one-on-one, it's us together in Jesus. And so there's this great treasure that we're gonna be able to be with other people we love forever and spend time with them, laugh with them, enjoy eternity together. So will there be streets of gold? I don't know, the Bible says there will, but those streets of gold won't matter. We're gonna be focused on Jesus and one another. Those are the treasures I look forward to. So here's a question back for you to think about. What has God given you that you can be generous with?
Sometimes we can tell something about a person by looking at them. For example, if someone's wearing a football uniform, we would guess that they played football. Or if someone was wearing a doctor's coat and a stethoscope, we would guess that that person was a doctor. Well, the religious leaders in Jesus' time thought that if they looked special and holy and obeyed all the rules, that they could earn God's love. But what Jesus was teaching was the opposite of that. Jesus taught that what's on the inside is much more important. God knows that we cannot obey all the time, but he loves us anyway. He just wants us to love him and glorify him and honor him. We often fail at those things because we're sinful, but if we tell God we're sorry and ask him for help, he'll help us. This week, look around and see how many things you can find that are different on the inside than they are on the outside. And remember that God looks at us on the inside. Have a great week!